I made it to week
14. America. There she is. Your ID.
Hi, Gina here with Sleevy G. I am very late on my videos. I've just been really busy with work. Lots and lots and lots of work. So just wanted to put something out here quickly just so I can keep up with this for myself too. So the last time I was made a video, I think it was week 11, I believe. So week 12, I weighed in at 232. I didn't even do my spiel. See, that's what you get when you don't do these videos, right? So, Gina, I had VSG surgery in Tijuana, Mexico with Dr. Ariel Ortiz on June the 2nd to this year, 2017. My highest weight ever recorded was 290. When I started with that surgeon's office, I was 277. The day of surgery, I was 261.5. And yeah, 261.5 the day of surgery, and then here I am at week 12. Well, I'm at week 14, but where I left off at was week 12. Week 12, I weighed in at 232.2, and that was a 1.2 loss from week 11. Week 13, I weighed in at 230.3. That was 1.9 pound loss from week 12. And then this week, which is week 14, Friday was week 14, I'm a few days late from that too. Friday was 14 weeks and I weighed in at 230.3. Didn't lose anything. But that's all right. I really don't sweat over this because I've pretty much been losing slowly all along and I am very, very cool with that. So anyway, the only thing I really have to say is it's been going okay. I've been working so much that I am definitely not following through with exercise too well at this time. So that's something I want to step my game up. And last week was, I guess, hell week for me. It was the first day of school. I run a school, so it was our first week. And I survived parent night and 14-hour days, and so I'm alive and well. So this coming week, things should start piping down a little bit for me. Actually, after this week, I really should be in a good place as far as work goes, so I need to step up my exercise. Another issue I'm having is I had such a good system going there for a while. Like, I always pack a bag wherever I go. I pack a bag full of food, different snacks and stuff like that. But the problem with it is that I was trying to follow very, you know, as much as I possibly could being this close out of surgery. I was trying to follow along with the keto rules. So my meals were all consistent with that. The only thing I would, I guess what I'm trying to say is now I'm finding planning hard, and not because I don't have time to plan, not because I'm not trying to plan. I'm planning, but I eat it one day and it's great, yum, yay. But then the next, it's like, ugh, I feel like I'm wasting a lot of food. Like, I can't eat like leftovers anymore to me. Or like, ugh, if I eat it once, I don't want to eat it again. So they're like, just, I don't know what that is, but it's just weird. Because before I was like, I didn't mind, I rolled up some kind of meat or something in a string cheese or something like that, and I knew I'd have a certain amount for the week planning, right? So I put it all together, whatever, but I can't do that. If I eat it one day, it does not mean that I'm going to be able to eat it anymore for the rest of the week, and maybe even a longer time. I'm kind of feeling like, man, like, my body, like, wants me to go back to soft foods. So I'm going to, actually, after I make this, I'm going to go to the store and make a couple different, like, low-carb soups. And I'm hoping that I am comfortable with that. But that's just how I'm feeling. Like, I don't know, just thinking about eating chicken. Me and chicken. Chicken was my favorite. I can't even, the only chicken I can eat, yeah, this probably isn't so good, but the only chicken I can stomach to eat right now is Chick-fil-A. So sometimes I do get like a little order of the Chick-fil-A nuggets and I take two of them out and I tear them up and I put them into the salad. I'm doing a lot of, I have had to step up and maybe do a couple protein shakes here and there because I know I'm not necessarily meeting where I'm supposed to be. I don't know what it is. Feeling a little ugh with food right now. Just, and then like I'll crave things and I'll think I want it. Like I thought I wanted chicken wings. And so like I ate chicken wings one day and I'm like, ugh, no, I can't eat. But they look good. I had leftovers. Like, oh yeah. Then, you know, the old me, I guess, comes back in my head and says, oh yeah, you want chicken wings. So go round two with these chicken wings. Ugh, can't eat these chicken wings. So now I'm just to the point now where like anything chicken other than Chick-fil-A chickens, just the thought of it makes me sick. Ugh, me and chicken. Mm-mm. So, I don't know. It's just, I'm in a weird place with food. Like, I don't even know what I like right now. I think I like something, and then I go to eat it, and I don't like it. So, I'm in a hard place. So that's why I'm going to try the soups and see. I'm even going to try soups with chicken in it. I'm just going to try and see if the softness, chicken in a soft way. I don't know. I don't know what I'm talking about here. I'm just trial and error. I think we're all just trial and error, right? Work in progress. Other than that, that's just what's been going on with me. Just super, super busy. I feel pretty good, as far as like my body goes. I'm feeling pretty good. I went through all my big girl clothes and, unfortunately I have a friend who could use them. So I gave them to her and she gave me all her, smaller sizes, so I fit into some 16 dress pants, which is pretty exciting, coming from a 20-22, so somewhere in that range. So I mean, I'm definitely losing and dropping. And actually the nutritionist said to me, she really wanted me to get one of those machines where that you hold out or whatever and weighs your body. I guess scales do that too, but I already bought a scale, so I'm not going to go back out and buy another one. So I'd rather just buy one of these machines. So I'm looking, does anybody, if you use that kind instead of the scale that tells you the fat percentage, I'm wondering if anybody could maybe tell me what brand I'm looking for, or is that the kind that I want, the kind that you hold out? I mean, I know there's some different, I don't know what I'm doing. So I'm definitely looking for help with that. Other than that, I want to keep this short and sweet. So thank you for watching and thanks for the new subscribers. Really appreciate it. I'm sorry I haven't been really around very much, but it's not. I do try to watch here and there when I can and just keep up with everyone. Seems like everybody's doing pretty good. So this is my 14th week. I got two more weeks in my 4-month period. I'm really hoping to be in the 220s the next time I come to you, but if I'm not, I guess I'll just hold on for the ride, but I'm pretty sure I'm gonna get there, eventually. But, anyway, thanks for watching. See ya.